In the live session on the future perspective of labor law and its impact on industries, and further, your future readiness and preparedness in connection with the expecting changes in the labor law as well as the future career in regard of the respective labor laws. So welcome you all in this live session or the masterclass today, and we are welcoming all you here in this live session today. Before going forward in this session, so I want to request you all that please share your location from where you have joined in the chat box so that I can welcome you all in this master session. However, there are many more members still joining, but it is 4:05 now, so we have to start the session so that we can cover all that different topics we are covering today with the present issues and the future perspective, then the creating of a USP for the future professional development. So Ravindra have joined from the Nagpur. Welcome you, Ravindra, in this live session today. And Rudrapur, Rahul Sachdeva, welcome Rahul Sachdeva in this live master session, specifically based on the management of the labor law compliances with the future perspective of the Indian law, which are going to change with this different scenario of the globalization as well as the different scenario and changing of the circumstances in Indian. So here I welcome you again, and further, let's begin with the session. So here I'm sharing the screen with you, and we are covering of all those topics which you have gone through maybe, and further I will share with you what you are getting in this program. After completing this program, as well as this program will be has scheduled for 2.5 hours. I request to all the members, please keep you muted at this time, and there are one and two. A request for you that keep the notepad as well as the pen with you and note down all your queries which you may have during the session on the notepad. And specifically, we will cover all the questions which you will have during the session at the end. So that's why we have kept separately the 30-minute time for the question and answer sessions. And I will try to make or resolve your queries related to the sessions, your questions, and the further your expectation related to the master session today. However, before going to and starting the session, it's learning what we are the topics covering. So what you are hearing, getting from this program. So this is a certification program, and you will get a participation certificate after completion of this program. And the certificate will be provided. We have the process for the certificate that will be provided on the Wednesday. And for that, you need to share your name, what name you want to mark on the certificate. So when the session will be completed, then after you will receive a mail with the templates which we are going to share with you today for your learning as well as your personal uses. You can use them as it is. There we do not have the copyright charges, and we do not have any copyright taken on that. So that will be all for you. So you can utilize them as it is. Then further, the recording of this video will be available by tomorrow. That will be shared with you through the links or emails. And then further, you will also learn the different perspective related to the systematic implementation in the organization related to the different labor law, and furthermore future readiness and preparedness for the changes and scenario changing in the India perspective of the different labor law. However, you are well aware about there are the four new codes which already has been enacted and ready to implement. So that may be possibly implemented from the new financial year from the April 2022. So welcome you again in this master session on the specifically managing of the compliances in the future perspective and its impact on the industries. Then furthermore, the professional readiness for complying with the changes requirement scenario of the labor law in India and the readiness for the future. Also, the perspective and the USP for the future professional development in the labor law compliances or the HR professional services. However, as per the learning prospect, we have divided this program in the three different rooms, and that are divided as per the relativity of the act or relativity of this master session today. So in the first session, we are covering specifically the present issue. When we understand the present issue, then we can correlate that or balance, link that with the future perspective, readiness and preparedness. And accordingly, in the second room or the second section of this master session, we will practically learn how we have to proceed systematic way to develop a compliance management portfolio for the future readiness. And for that, in the second section, we will share all those documents which you required at your workplace front to implement the changes in the future in your organization, so you can utilize them as your references, and that will be ready to use for you. They have to only have small changes in that. Then related to the question and answer, we have specifically kept the 30 minutes for the question and answer. It when we go beyond the 30 minutes also, it will be depend on your queries and how much questions you have for the end, where you want to resolve your queries. So you can ask all those questions openly, and then you can also ask those questions in chat box, or otherwise if anyone wants to record their voice and they can ask the voicing questions, so they can ask us to, so you can unmute that time and then ask the question. However, in between, if one or two questions I can also pick up, so that you can ask them in the chat box. So now let's going with this session specifically here. First of all, it is very important to us and all of us here that we should know where we are interacting with whom and what is the platform. So specifically today in this live session, this is our 31st live session when we have started it in the this year. We started from this program from the July itself. So it is the 31st of the live session related to the developing of people for the future readiness related to the labor law compliances. So you are here interacting with the platform. So that is the SBR Learning Studio. And this SBR Learning Studio is a digital learning solution or services providing for the corporates. And this platform, as well as the organization we have established in May 2020, it is now 1.5 year old association as well as the organization. And we started this organization as with the objective of providing the best learning platform to everyone with a reasonable cost. And then we have specifically a vision where we are thinking about to educate the 100 million people by 2040 with the best of knowledge that need to cater the true professionalism as per the going the changes in the professional scenario or the work environment. And furthermore, however, it is our long-term vision, then we are on the mission specifically where we are going to educate around 25,000 students every year to reaching to this vision of the 100 million by 2040. But further, it is not just we have to associate with the people and just give them the learning as well as then after we do not have any connection. We have a value specifically developed. When you are interacted with us, you will become the member of our Great Learning Leap community, and where you can ask any question, where we can provide you the solution and the your queries. So for that, we are looking with the value to make with you the long-term association. So furthermore, if we talk about the different types of services, we are associated digitally and the physically also. We are in the different types of HR and specifically learning services. So we also provide for the organization, the Pan India Learning services through the different associated partners throughout India. Then we have the corporate consulting services, individual and group mentoring services specifically related to the developing of the people in the professional front. Then there are the services related to the professional resume developing for the professionals, and then the digital learning solution we provide as a platform we are discussing today. This is one of the digital learning platform where we have different type of the live program as well as the recording program available. Then after we also serving the specifically the professional or the people who are the aspirant or transforming them with the global leaders. So for that we are providing the digital library services also. And in the digital learning solution, we have five type of solution for the perspective of individual as well as the corporate and the groups to develop them as a professional with the requirement of the future need, as we have discussed in the previous session with our vision and mission. So there is the different types of development program and solution we have that are the personal developments, then the professional development, intermediate leadership, and the business leaders development program we have on our platform that are the digitally as well as the physically too. Then furthermore, it is the first interaction with us where we are interacting in the live today, but furthermore in the future, how you can interact with us. So there are the different types of platform we have available where you can connect with us. So we have one dedicated website where you can explore about us, whom we are, where we have the professional expertise facilitator related to the different trainer. and providing the solution specifically for the development of the individual and the groups in different domains of the professionals. Then where you can connect to us, you have received already the communication from us through an email, that is the SBR Studio 2436, where you can connect with us for the future. If you have any query, you can write on that. But further, thereafter, you have also provided the community. You can connect to those community. If you have any inquiry from the professional friend, you can ask that. We will try to resolve all those queries as soon as possible. We can give you the solution for that. Apart from that, we are available also the social media and the social platform where we provide the insights and developing and a motivational tool and a learning tool free of cost for the community as well as the other people who are connecting with us. So that specifically the soft skill learning, we have one dedicated social media platform. Then the skill who want to develop their specifically the skill related to the HR profession. So they have the specifically one dedicated platform. And third one is where the people, they want to learn from the global leaders book, but they do not have time for specifically to spending time for reading the book. So we're providing the solution for the different books as a digital library, as well as specifically where there are the some short summaries from the different types of book, which is in the transformation, the development of people development, professional development. So you can also check out this, the short summary we are providing. Then the actionable idea, how you can implement those idea in your personal life, that types of guidelines are available there. So these are the different types of platform where you can connect with us. Then furthermore, it come to the digital platform where we are providing the digitally development program. So there we have specifically the personal development as of now. In total, as our platform, there are more than 15 number of the existing live program we have available. And then further, we are also providing the different types of the development program in the personal development. That are the essential skills and the professional development program. Then in the professional development specifically, we'll be providing the solution related to the different skill where you can develop yourself as a professional for the future required skill. Then we have certain programs, one or two on our platform related to the entrepreneurial development. The people have aspirant to work their own, so they can also start with that. Then after, there are the other programs related to the leadership development for the top leader of the organization and corporates, then the top CXO level people. So this is all about our services as well as what we are at as the SBR Learning Studio. So this platform with whom you are interactive in this live session. And right now, with the learning of the insights as well as the future perspective of the labor law and its solution and the USP further with the labor laws or its changes going to be for the future. So my name is K.S. Srinivasan, as I have more than 18 years of experience in HR domain as well as the labor law compliance specifically. I have worked for the Indian as well as the global MNCs in India as well as the Southeast Asia. So I have MBA, LLB, MBA, HR, as well as I have a certification from the SHRM in the HR management. So this is all about the HR, SBR Learning Studio, and about me. Now, it comes to now when we start with the perspective of the future perspective of the Indian labor law and its impact on the industries. Then your preparedness for the future changes. And it is one thing which I want to share with you in the future, the labor law are going to be very terrific to change and impacting the organization. So that's why you need to be well prepared in the advance. So that we are trying to making that preparedness in 2 days, in the 2 hours and 30 minutes, so that you can get a whole picture of the practicality, how you have to proceed for the future. So further, first it is, we need to be understand that when we are going to be becoming ready for the future, so we need to be assess the present issues as well as the pain point, why this area still have the pain point for the organization, for corporates and the service provider. So we need to be assess first that, then we can go in the next session as well as the next room where we have the practical session related to the implementation of the compliance management portfolio in your organization. So here we are covering the different types of the present existing labor law that have the very impactful or impact on the organization, and that impact is still a pain to the business owner as well as the organization and the occupiers. And then we will also cover of the future perspective of the four new codes which are going to be implemented from the new financial year as of now expected. So furthermore, going into the session and covering all those topics, here I have one and two questions for you, starting the learning the practicality, understanding the current perspective and the pain point for the employer as well as the organization with existing labor law. Then we can assess that and balance that with the future changes or the future perspective of the labor laws in Indian industries. So here is the question for you. This is one and the simple question. Specifically, this program is also to developing the capability for the future perspective. So that this question is that if you are a specialist in the labor law compliances and managing the different type of labor laws in organization, so you should well aware about the key success skill or the specialist skill of the labor law compliance in the organization. So question is for you, what are the important and specifically the success skill for a labor law compliance specialist? So please write down your answer in the chat box next 1 minute. So I'm waiting for that. Then we will start or jump in this session directly and assess the present issue for the employer with the existing labor law. So the question, I'm repeating it here again. What are the success skill required for a labor law compliance specialist? Even that is the HR professional, that is the labor law compliance services provided to the organization. These skills mandatory required to them so that you can succeed as a professional or a service provider for the organization. Because the scenario of businesses and services is more or very much competitive. So that's why you need to have some unique proposition for inside you or within your organization, within your services, so that you can compete with the competition of the businesses and the professional. So Gyana is answering discipline is first. Okay, thank you so much. But it is the very basic for this. Discipline is a mandatory condition for working somewhere. It can also connected with the consistency as well as the persistency for the professional related to their accountability and the responsibility. However, it is a one answer of the basic of the thing. But furthermore, we have to cover up the time also what we have scheduled. So here I'm sharing with you the four success qualities and skill of a labor law compliance specialist. That is the number one. That is the vigilant. The labor law compliance specialist should be more vigilant so that they can comply and assess all that future changes and implement and assure in your organization. And second one is the foresighted. What is going to be changed? Now it is the period of foresightness for us when these four new codes already enacted and ready to implementation. What is going to be happen when that will be implemented? However, many of people are aware about that when practically many people have tried to work on that, learning some new skills for that. But it is required the foresightness to you, because still there are the many perspective under these four new codes also which are going to be changed. When it will be actually implemented, maybe during that time there may be certain other changes too. Then third quality, or specifically the success skill of a labor law compliance specialist, that is the accountability. And the fourth one is the responsibility. These are the four unique select proposition of the labor law compliance specialist, which will make you unstoppable in your professional front. And that is going to be a new USP in the labor law compliance management and for your progression in the future as a professional. And also in this program, we are also developing these four skills within you when you will tomorrow join your organization back in your office. So that these four skills will develop with you, you can become an administrator of the labor law compliances. And you can have those ideas in mind what you have to do for the future to make your organization ready with that. So now, let's start with the covering all the topics specifically where we are listed out related to the different industrial aspects. So if we talk about there in the broadly, there are the different three types of industrial sectors here, which we categorize them in the primary, secondary, and the territorial. If we divide them in the three categories, so it come as the primary sectors are those where the natural resources processing businesses or the processes happen. Second is come to the secondary, where the majorly the process happens related to the transforming of one raw material to the another shape and part and different shape. So there is the very critical process involved in the secondary industries. And then it come to the territorial industries, those industries which are involved in the. So when we divide or when we broadly see the three different industrial sectors as well as the three different industrial sector, when we come up with the and then in the reference of the existing labor law, so there is the one major, the secondary sector of the industrial establishment, that is the manufacturing, specifically where the 60% of the organization or the business are into manufacturing, and most of the existing labor laws that are applicable as well as applied to the industries specifically. Or so that's why we are covering in this end for the understanding and better learning or and having a better understanding related to the existing labor law and its issues. So we will cover for the example as a manufacturing industry. However, we are also covering the factories perspective, then shop and commercial, then after the connecting different labor laws which required, there are the multiple obligations to the employer. And that's why after the independence of India, it is around 76 years and the labor laws and labor issues are still persist there. So that is the biggest challenge and the pain point for the employer as of now. And in the future, it is going to be more impactful. How? We will discuss that in the later section of this master session today. So let's begin with understanding the present issue, and specifically when there are any manufacturing establishment. So there are the certain law which you require to be comply with for understanding with the different obligations related to the factories also. First, we are covering of as an example as a factories of manufacturing, they have been covered under the Factories Act. When it applies the Factories Act to an establishment, there you need to be required to facilitate some provision in your organization, and that are mandatory. If those facilitation and provisions not implemented in the organization by the employer, so that it will be a pain point for the organization. Just understanding the different obligation under the factories. First, when you are starting your organization, starting a commencement or commencing a business, so there you require a certain types of approval that are the mandatory. When those approval has been granted to you, there has been certain condition attached with that own certain condition that approval has been granted for the organization. Then after majorly, the Indian labor law have three major objectives. That is the health, safety and welfare. That is the mandatory provision of every labor law that required to be implemented in every organization. And if we see related to the, or in the specifically the Factories Act 1948, there are the different types of the provision. Specifically, the Factory Act is the act that regulates the working hour and condition of employment in the factory specifically. So all that provision which has been provided with the connecting labor law, that you need to be implement in that. Like the safety committee, you need to form in that, and then welfare measure you need to be provided. Then the employment of the young person you have to assured. However, it is prohibitive in the another law, but is it provided the some guidelines as well as the reference in the Factories Act. Then there you required to display certain notices, and that is the mandatory requirement which you have to display in your organization. And fire and safety separate provision, separately policies related to the safety and environment. Then if the organization manufacturing maximum have the hazard process, what is the quantum of the hazard process for that you need to obtain separate license for that, or otherwise you have to facilitate the norm on that. In that cases, there are the different types of the obligation there. If such obligations are not fulfilled, there is the provision of 3 years of imprisonment for the employer and fine up to 2 lakh rupees or cancellation of the business or the factory license. If that happens, so it will impact the employer image in three perspectives: one, their business, their personal image, and their reputation with the competitor. So that's why it is still the pain point for the organization as well as the employer with complying with the regulation of the existing labor. So here we are covering up the existing pain point for the employer. If these obligation did not fulfilled by the employer, so there are the certain provision of the that the imprisonment for 3 years as well as the fine up to 2 years, 2 lakh rupees for the employer. Similarly, the industry, those are not covered under the factories, that will covered under the Shop and Commercial Establishment Act. However, the Shop and Commercial Establishment Act is a state enactment, but it is mandatory requirement under the provision of the Shop and Commercial Establishment, because the Shop and Commercial Establishment is the act which regulate, monitor and define the working hour, condition of services and employment in the Shop and Commercial Establishment. So that's why you need to obtain the registration under the provision of the act within 19 days of commencement of your business, which come under the provision of the Shop and Commercial Establishment. And similarly, as I mentioned that the Indian labor law have the major three objective that need to be comply and implemented, and that is regulated by the every labor law. So there, in perspective of the different industry, there are around 78 number of the different labor laws which are applied to the different industries. However, the maximum number of the labor law, existing labor law, that apply to the factories as well as the manufacturing specifically. So when we come up with the industries which are covered under the Shop and Commercial Establishment, so there you need to be facilitate or specifically make the provision for the different condition of employment and working hour in your organization. Like that, you need to be assured the employment of adults and their working hours in the shops and commercial establishment. And also you need to be very much strict about the restriction of the double employment of employee you are engaging in your shop and commercial establishment. Then separately, even though there are not that the engaging of the young person in the organization, that is prohibited, but for the certain circumstances as a trainees and for making the future manpower ready, so there are the provision also provided for engaging of the certain adolescents in your organization, but they, for that you need to be separately obtain certain approval for that. And then you need to be assured the opening and closing hours under the in the shops and commercial establishment where the provision has been provided under the shop and commercial establishment. Then specifically, the period of rest and weekly holidays, you need to be provided to every employee of the shop and commercial establishment. And wages for holidays, it is defined. So however, when we talk about the different existing labor law, it is not that the factories, if not, saying that you need to be pay the wages for the holidays, but it is interconnected. When it is defining the working condition, working hours, condition of employment and service in the industry, so in that perspective, if an point of discussion and point of concern is not cleared in one act, so that will be referred to the another act, because the Indian labor law, they have the same objective for all the three major objective, that is your health, welfare and safety. So all that provision you need to be followed. So it come to that the different types of obligations which has been prescribed under the shop and commercial establishment, like the time and condition of the payment, which need to be decided and that need to be implemented by the organization in the shop and commercial establishment. Further, their provision of the sick leaves and casual leaves also, and the precautions against the fire and maintaining of the different records for your every facility you are facilitating under the provision of the existing labor law which are applicable to your organization. Similarly, if you see under the shop and commercial establishment, if these obligations which are obliged for the organization not fulfilled, there is the provision of the fine up to 1 lakh rupees and cancellation of the license. However, for the shop and commercial establishments, their employer and occupiers, the provision of the imprisonment is not available there, but the fine and the cancellation of the business license also impact their three major domains, their businesses, their financial, as well as their personal, which among the competitor. So that's why it is still the pain for the industrial organization, the existing labor law and its compliance with the. And similarly, when there are the industries specifically, like we have covered the factories and shop and commercial establishment, then when these industries are there and you are engaging the manpower or man force in your organization. However, it is the mandatory part of the any organization and establishment. Without the four factor, that is the man, machine, material and method, you cannot start or commence a business or it cannot be existed. So the men are the, or the manpower is specifically the major component of the businesses. When you engage the men in your organization, and that men are specifically, or we can say that the manpower, that are specifically the major workforce and the component for processing your businesses and achieving the goal of your businesses. The businesses has been decided and that has been established for making some profit. And when the organization are making the profit for their businesses, so in the mostly the share of making that profit is the manpower or that human capital which you are engaging. When you are engaging such manpower, so in that case it is required, you need to be share something with them, but it is not obligatory for the employer before 1965. So that's why in the era of after independence, 1947 to 1965, there was the discriminatory behavior of the employer with the employee, and so that's why there was also the bonding labor system available. Then after the enactment was enacted in 1965, where it has been defined or regulated to the employer that they need to be assured the some share of their profit with the employee they are engaging. And specifically, there has been determined when there are the certain organization, there is a specific number which you have employed or covered in a specific proceeding, and that the proceeding 12 months of any day, the act will and its provision will become applicable and applies to the organization. In that case, it is mandatory for the organization, you need to pay the 8.33 of a minimum bonus. However, it is also that there are the some exemption provided for the new establishment, but as a labor law compliance specialist as well as the labor law compliance administrator, you need to understand that the exemption for the payment making of the bonus to the workmen, it is for the new incorporation, not for the new establishment. For example, you can understand it like that: one organization or a company, they have the different factories in different state, and now establishing a new factory in some other state. And in that case, under the provision of the Payment of Bonus Act 1965, that factory is not the new establishment, that is the old establishment of that particular incorporation. In that case, you need to pay the bonus from the when that business is starting in that establishment. And similarly, there are certain record you have to maintain under the provision of that. So when these provisions which has been provided or which has been imposed as the obligation for the employer or organization, if not fulfilled, there is the provision of the 6 month of imprisonment and fine up to 1,000 rupees. So the organization, they need to be assured that. And furthermore, however, many of the organization, they are not assuring these provisions. That's why they are still facing the problem related to the complying with the requirement of the existing labor law. Similarly, there are the factories and shop and commercial establishments, and every establishment, they are engaging the workforce from or through, which is known in the corporate term as outsource. When you are outsourcing the manpower for your business processes, that will be comply, that's required to be compliance with the Contract Labor Act 1970, and under the provision of the 1970, there are certain provision provided which need to be complied by the both the parties. So in that case, party will be the employer, principal employer, as well as the service provider, the contractor or the outsourcer service provider. So in that case, it is required, the obligation which may be, which are compulsory to be fulfilled by the organization as well as the principal employer and the contractor or the service provider, that is the compulsory registration of the establishment, and the contract lies that we contract license by the service provider. So in that case, there the employer need to be obtain the registration first, then you need to be give a engagement certificate to that contractor where you are engaging 20 or more people from a contractor. Then after all that facility, you need to be facilitated to them, which has been prescribed in the Indian labor law, the majorly three objective, the health, welfare, and safety. However, you may have question that the employee that are not directly employed by the principal employer. However, you are engaging the manpower through the contractor as well as the service provider. That manpower is not deployed at the location, at the site of that particular contractor. It will be deployed at your site. When physically the manpower is working at your site, so it is the responsibility of the principal employer to make sure all the obligation as well as the provision of the Contract Labor Act 1917. However, separately, the Contract Labor Act 1970 also make the provision that the principal employer need to assure all the compliances under the provision of the contract labor for the contractor also. So it doesn't mean that you have to practically just make their all records. So it need to be assured that this principal employer need to supervise all that compliance by the contractor. Then maintaining of all records, facilitating of the provision, that is the part of the principal employer, but other provision or making the record, it is the part of the your vendor or the contractor specifically, but you need to be assured that it is the responsibility of the principal employer. Then if these obligations not fulfilled by the contractor as well as the principal employer, so there is the provision of 3 months of imprisonment and fine up to 1,000 rupees, and also cancellation of your registration provisions are also there. So if any obligation not fulfilled, so there is also the remain same issue with the existing level of for the employer. It is increasing the pain of the employer related to which will impact their organization, their businesses, their image, as well as their finance, if the compliances are not fulfilled and obligation are not fulfilled. Similarly, when you are engaging the manpower in your organization, so that you are engaging them for this rendering their services, and in that services, what the employee are rendering, you need to be paid to them the amount which will be mutually decided by the employer and employee. So what it should be decided and what it can be decided by the employer and employee, and who will decide it. So for that, there are the provision of the minimum wages, so that the minimum wage specifically define the minimum limit of paying out, the minimum limit of the paying out for the rendering of services which the employer need to be assured. Below the minimum wage, which has been prescribed by the appropriate government under the Minimum Wage Act, the appropriate government is the different state government, because the different state have their own minimum wages as per their criteria specifically. However, the criteria are same, but is the condition of the geography as well as their business, that the financial condition and the revenue generation. So then after, there are the certain, as the labor law compliance administrator, what are the current issue with that, what you need to be considered, and you need to be vigilant in that. So one thing is that whatever the wage has been prescribed by the state government, however, every year that has been revised in true time, so that you need to be assured. So it should not be below than that wage which has been prescribed by the state government as a minimum wage. And second, which you need to be assured, that the minimum wage which has been prescribed, you cannot bifurcate that wage into the different components, or the bifurcate that into the different component. It should be in the same component. Then you need to be decide the time and mode of the payment of wages skill wise, that has been defined specifically, so that you need to be paid to them. It is not that you can pay the same minimum wage to all. It has been defined as a skill wise, so you need to be minimum pay that. Then after, you need to be maintain the certain records for that. If these obligations, specifically the mandatory two obligations are there, where you need to be pay the minimum wage which has been prescribed, and secondly, that you cannot bifurcate the minimum wage into different components, if these obligations are not fulfilled, that there are the provision of 6 months of imprisonment and fine up to 1,000 rupees for the employer. And it, you need to be similarly, regulate it and the monitor it for the if you are engaging the contractor also. When this is the minimum wage, you need to be paid that. But the there are also the question remain if that minimum wage, when it should be paid. So still the employer is not responsible. But however, before the enactment of the minimum wage in India, there was already one enactment available before the independence, that the Payment of Wage Act 1936, which regulated, defined the specifically the wages and assuring the wages or the due amount, whichever is due to the any employee who has been worked for the organization or render their services for the businesses or the organization, establishment or employer, that need to be paid to them. And the Payment of Wage Act 1936 specifically defining the obligation for the employer that they need to assure or make the payment or assuring the payment on time for the everyone or every employee, even that is existing and that employee has been exit for the organization. So there are the certain obligations which has been prescribed under the act specifically, that the responsibility of the employer. It is conditioned that the principal employer, if it's the case of the contractor, then the payment to every person whom had been employed or has been employed in the organization by him, and that wages which is required to be paid under the Minimum Wage Act as well as the Payment of Wage Act, or however there is the agreement when the factories are there, between the agreement between the employer and employee for the service condition. So whatever is defined there, you need to be, whatever is agreed there before taking the employment in any organization. So the Payment of Wage Act regulate such provision that you need to be assured every wages which is due to anyone that need to be paid to that person. Then secondly, there the responsibility of the employer is the fixation of the wage period for the making of the payment. So there it is provided. However, you may all are well aware that if there is that condition for the below 1000 number, so it is defined that the it should be paid before the 7th of the proceeding month, or if that is the headcount in your organization are above than 1000, so it will be 10th. But if that is the case, something it should not be exceed the 30 days. And similarly, there that the time and mode of payment you need also to decide. However, the provision provided that it should be in the working hours in the organization. But further, the new provision has been made now, it is that provided that you need to be transact every payment through the electronic transaction. So the condition specifically that paying it at the working hour is not as a mandatory now. But earlier when it was there, you have to pay it in the physical cash. So that's why it should be required, it should be paid in the or during the working hours. So similarly, there is also defined what is the deduction required and prescribed and allowed under the law, which you can deduct it. So as per the Payment of Wage Act, there is provided that up till the 75% of the wages you can deduct from the employer wages, which is due and payable for the wage period. And that is also one internal condition. In the case of statutory, with the statutory, it may be 75%. But when the statutory is not there, so it should not be more than 50%. So it is the condition. If you not fulfilled these obligations, so there is the provision of the 1 month of imprisonment for the employer and the fine up to 1000 rupees. So employer means it is specifically the occupier who has been defined, who has the ultimate control on the affairs of your organization. So he will be responsible for that. It is the one and the important. When you are engaging the employee or the workforce for your organization, and that you are engaging them for the as the employee of on the permanency, but when the employee, they are rendering their services to the organization, so what should be and what is your reward to them so that they can be motivated and they can also make their efforts to make your organization profitable. Earlier, there was no such provision available, but in the 1975, the Indian government that considered the payment of gratuity for the industrial worker or industrial establishments too. So that also, it is provided under the provision that when an employee work for an organization for 5 years and more, they should be rewarded with the long service award. So that is condition under the that the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, that the employee, when they are completing the 5 year or services, you need to be paid to them the certain amount as their service reward or the long services reward, so that they can be motivated in the organization. And additionally, that is the one separate condition and which you should be aware about, that gratuity is one of the law which providing the statutory right to the employee to claim the gratuity if they have completed the 5 year. And one thing, you may have the question now that how to calculate the 5 years. So however, the law, it does not say that there is a specific period provided, but in the, there was one case in the Supreme Court, the one judgment the Supreme Court has been given related to the calculation or making the calculating of the eligibility period or claiming of the gratuity. So when specifically the one employee will become eligible for the claiming of the gratuity, so there it will be the 4 completing year and 240 working days in the industry specific. However, we are covering here it as the manufacturing. But when there are the seasonal industries, so in the seasonal industry, it should be at least 119 days work for the season, whatever they have, 6 months, 9 months, whatever is the season is there. So it should be work at least 119 days so that the person will become eligible for claiming the gratuity from the employer. So then after, there are the certain obligation you need to be facilitate and you need to be check out in your organization, if specifically in the case of the exit employee, does they completed the 5 year and has been paid their gratuity. If these obligation does not fulfill, there is a provision of 1 year of imprisonment and fine up to 1,000 rupees. Existing labor law regulated the different provision, and there are also the provision related to the social securities. However, the gratuity is one of the provision, the social security, and which providing the retirement financial benefit to the employee specifically. And similarly, there are the other existing labor law which regulate and define the social security in the organization as per the existing labor law. So similarly, there are, you are well aware, there are the employee provident fund and miscellaneous provision. That is also the scheme provided that the facilitating the industrial worker or the employee after their retirement, and it is also known as the retirement provision for the industrial workmen. So further, it is the certain obligations for the under the provision of the EPFO to the employer specifically, which you need to be and which are the majorly mandatory to comply with the requirement of the provision of the EPFO Act 1952 by the employer. So first of all, it is that the every organization who is and who have the 10 or more employee in the organization, they need to be covered under the EPF. For that, you need to obtain the registration and approval specifically. Then the mandatory provision which you need to be comply, that is the deduction, recovery and remittance. It is the responsibility of the principal employer to assure that. And secondly, it should be deduction, recovery and remittance as per the defines regulations. And secondly is that the employer cannot reduce, if the organization want to reduce the wages that the PFV, they don't want to pay in as amount they are assuring. So that it is the mandatory requirement that the, or mandatory obligation for the employer, you cannot reduce the wages where you have started with the contribution deducted for an employee. So you need to be assured it. When you have structuring your salary structure in your organization, so you need to structure it as per the referring the provision of the EPFO also. And in the future, you cannot reduce that wages. And then there are the certain records you require to be maintained. And however, now it is the digital, but there are the other provisions you need to be facilitate them. If these obligations, it is specifically providing the three main facility to the employer. One is the employee provident fund scheme. Second one is the pension scheme. Third one in the insurance scheme. And all that will be based on the contribution you have decided to deduct on that wage which you have decided for their employee. And then when these provisions are not fulfilled by the employer, so there are the provision of 1 year of imprisonment and fine up to 5,000 rupees for the employer. Similarly, the EPF Act, there are the another act which regulate the social security for the industrial employment. So it is specifically providing the facility in case of uncertainty as well as the insurance specifically. So it comes in the provision of the Employee State Insurance Act 1948, where every organization, where every 10 or more employees, so that need to be covered under the ESIC Act. Then similarly, as per the provision of the Act, so it is the responsibility of the principal employer in case of their direct employee as well as the contractual as well, or the outsource employee, that deduction, recovery and remittance is the major responsibility of the principal employer. And also then the employee who are within the capping of the ESIC, the 21,000 rupees wages, that all member needs to be insured under the ESIC, that Employee State Insurance Act. Then here after that, under the provision of the Employee State Insurance Act, it is provided and specifically prescribed that the principal employer to be pay contribution in the first instance for the ESIC case. So you need to be assured every deduction, recovery and remittance of the or employee related to the Employee State Insurance Act. If these obligations are not fulfilled, there is a provision of 3 years of imprisonment and fine up to 10,000 rupees. And also, when these different law which are existing and regulating the different perspective, even that the working hour condition of employment, then the different wages, making and sharing the profit, then long service award providing and assuring that, then further the social security. Then after there in the organization, how you have to engage the employee and what should be their ideal code of conduct as part of the employee as part of the employer also. So there are the provision also defined in the Industrial Establishment Standing Order Act 1946. However, it is assuredly provided that need to be applied for the manufacturing and the factory specifically, but it is also applicable for the other industrial estate as this model standing order. So it is also known as the that the code of conduct and the condition of employment. So if you are working in any organization which are the service organization, so there every organization, they have the agreement with the employee when you are engaging them. That is known as the name as appointment letter. So in that appointment letter, there are different clauses incorporated and that defining the condition on how condition you have to work, what should be your timing and where you will be deployed and when you can be transferred. So everything has been defined in that. Did you ever that thought that how and where these condition has been referred and derived through this appointment letter? Specifically, that are from the Industrial Standing Order, Industrial Establishment Standing Order Act 1946. When there are the certain that the obligation specifically, the certifying standing order, it is for the factory specifically when there are the 100 and more employees. But further, the references you need to be take place when there are the other industries at the model standing order. Then you need to be assured every condition and when that condition, what you have agreed with the employee that you are not complying with. So there are the provision of the fine under the provision of the Industrial Standing Order Act 1946. And similarly, in the latest there something happened in the our society or environment. So that's why in the 2013, one new enactment was imposed as well as enacted by the government to protecting specifically the female worker at the workspace related to their harassment at the workplace. So this is the one of the new enactment and the majorly one of the important enactment for the employer which required to assure in the organization and there are the different obligations prescribed and defined under the provision of the act which you require to be fulfilled. So it is mandatory for the every organization which is defined under the POSH Act 2013 that every organization who are engaging or 10 or more workmen in their organization, they need to be constitute the internal complaint committee. However, the employees are less than 10 or more. Subodh is asking for, as per the appointment letter of the model standing order, PAT defined as age of the retirement should be 50 or 55 or 60. However, as of the that average defining the retirement age, it is the 58. So it should not be 60. However, in the different standard for the governmental employee is there. The fourth class and class divided for the governmental sector, it is separately and monitored separately. But for the that the private sector as well as the industrial establishment, it should be or it is the defined as 58 years. Then similarly, we are covering here the different obligations under the Posh Act 2013. So that is specifically where you have to frame the policies for implementation of the constitution of the internal complaint committees as well as the prevention and prohibition or the redressal specifically related to the harassment of workmen, that the women specifically at the workplace. Then you need to be display the order and the that constitution of the IC committee, then display the penal consequences in case anybody found guilty, then the in case of the sexual harassment of women at workplace. Then you need to be provide the periodical adequate training to the Posh law to the IC members also. And further, the awareness session for every employee related to the harassment of women at workplace. Then the provision that you need to be submit the annual report to the district officer under the provision of the Posh Act, the authority, which and who regulate and regulate specifically the provision of the act and where it will be complied with. So that has been the district officer, which has been described and specified under the act. Then there it is the mandatory provision for the employer that you need to be assured the facility or necessarily facilitate and provide the assistance to the IC committees when they have any penal consequences, and also you need to be implement the recommendation of the IC committees. Then now you may have the question that what is the formation of those IC committees. So at the level of the organization, ideally at the top, it should be at least 3 members. So where 1 member should be from the outside of the organization, you can engage that from any NGO. However, any individual person who has the experience as well as the certified in the Posh related activities and the he has certification in the certain the Posh related provision, so he or she can be the 1 member and 2 should be inside the organization. So it is the briefly on the top there should be, and then you can divide it as per the requirement and the total number of in your organization you can decide it. So under the provision of the Posh Act 2013, if the provision of the act is not applied, is not fulfilled, so there is the provision of the 1 lakh of the fines and cancellation of the business license for the employer. So these are the different existing labor laws which have the different provision provided required to be facilitated by the employer in the organization. And if not fulfilled, that are still the pain point for the organization. Then the professional, like the HR people as well as the labor law service providing people, so you need to be very much aware, and specifically you should have very much vigilant and foresighted, accountable and responsible related to these provisions. And that you need to be guide your organization as well as the employer specifically, that implementing all these provisions is the mandatory procedure and the requirement for your organization when you have to save your organization and release the pain of your employer in case of specifically the impacting of the businesses, financial and their personal image among the competitor. But then further, as we have discovered and understood the existing labor law and its perspective and still the issue with the complying for by the organization and its impact on the organization. Furthermore, so there are the 4 new codes which has been enacted by the government and that are going to be implemented from the new financial year. So that codes are nothing but some reform has been done there, and the existing different labor law has been merged with these codes. So if we know about, there are the 4 different codes like the Wage Code 1920, the Industrial Relation Code 2020, Then the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition Code 2020. The Social Security Code 2020. So these are the four different codes which has been enacted, but that are not separately enacted from the new one, that are the merger of the existing labor law, which we have some of covered in the beginning of this, where the existing issue with the labor law. So what happened in the 2016 or 70, the government, they have decided to merge the centralized law, 29 law exactly, with the four new codes. And the law which are already existing and that define the wages, so that laws are merged in one code given the name as the Wage Code 2019. And other side, the existing labor law or the Labor Act, which regulate, define and monitor the industry relation specifically, so that has been merged under the, with some reforms and some changes, that has been merged under the Industrial Relation Code 2020. And similarly, the Wage Code of 2020 and Industrial Relation Code 2020, there are the different existing labor law which regulate the working hour, condition of employment, safety, welfare and working condition or occupational health. So that all the laws or existing act has been merged under the provision of the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition Act 2020. And then the fourth law, which is the fourth code, which is known as the Social Security Code 2020, and there the existing labor law or the Labor Act, which define, regulate and monitor the social security in the organization, that was merged under the Social Security Act 2020. So these are the specifically the four new codes are the merger and crux of these existing labor law, the 29 central existing law, which has been provided some reform and some standardization there. Then it has been merged as well and given the new name, the wage, the different four new labor code, the Wage Code 2019, Industrial Relation Code 2020, Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition Code 2020, then the Social Security Code 2020. So now let's see when these four new codes will be implemented, what is going to be changed. So if you see from the upper side and from the top, so there you can see that there are some reforms already happened for the organization. So as specifically, when there are going to be some changes, when you have to maintain certain records and maintain the register. So if you see in the case of certain register, so as of now, with the existing labor law, we are maintaining near about 40 number of the different records and register. When these four new codes will be implemented, so it will be only 11. Then in case of the return, so as of now, we are submitting the different types of return in the different forms. So that is calculated as 22. But when these four new codes will be implemented, it will be consolidated 4. And then the license. So before, at the existing, with the existing labor law, it are the 2, but after the new codes will be implemented, it will be 3 only. Then the different type of displays you have to display. So as per the existing law, it are the 20. So here specifically, we are just looking out for the purview. What is going to be changed when these four new codes will be implemented? So if you see from the upside and the from front side, so what is the changes happen? So specifically, when the HR people who are dealing with the labor law compliance specifically, it is considered only the just maintaining of the records. So that's why the HR function and specifically the labor law compliance function does not consider as the productive function in the organization. And the people who are dealing with the compliance, they consider it just for the time consuming job. But in the second section, you will understand why the compliance is going to be a big perspective for the future, where it will also help you to progress your career as well as it will also help you to have a specific weightage in your organization as well as the making or assuring your organization well compliance and then also becoming the strategist as the labor law compliance strategy in your organization, where you can help the organization saving them from the different impacts. But further, Here we are discussing specifically the different types of record which require to be maintained under the provision of the act. Then it is related to the different relation, that is the registration we have to obtain under the existing labor law. When these four new codes will be implemented, as of now with the existing labor law, there we are required to five number of registration required to be obtained. But when these four new codes will be implemented, that the registration will be that revised to the three only. But there are the remittance specifically under the SIC and PF, so it will remain same as per the existing law. Applicant, just an overview related to the changes happen, and from the front side you can see that there are the good reforms for the specifically for the organization where you required to not maintain different types of records, and it will also ease your working somewhere. It is also when you have to maintain certain records, but furthermore it is going to be a big impact for the organization when these four new codes will be implemented. So that's why when we talk in the beginning, it is required your readiness and the preparedness for the future. So that scenario I'm sharing it here with you, what is the impact going on the organization and the businesses when these four new codes will be implemented, and how it will help you to make progressive in your organization, as well as you need to be very much vigilant, foresighted, accountable and responsible now, and that for quality that will be developed within you for becoming progressive in your organization. So let's see the scenario, what will be happen when these four new codes will be changes. However, it is the resemblance and merger of the existing labor law. There is nothing changed. It are the merger of the existing labor law. If you see the code on wage 2019, so that is the merger of the four existing labor law. So that are the payment of wage act, that minimum wage act, the payment of bonus act, and the full remuneration also. When we see, we have discussed that different types of the obligation under the existing labor law that are the biggest pain point for the employer. Why? So there are the provision of the imprisonment as well as the fines when the obligations are not fulfilled. If you see, with the existing labor law which has been merged in the code on wage 2019, so there, if any obligation does not fulfilled by the employer, the minimum fine that can be imposed to an employer 500 rupees, and maximum it is the 20,000 rupees, and the imprisonment that is minimum 1 month and maximum 6 months. But when the wage, that code on wage 2019 will be implemented, so the changes in the financial is going to be impacting the organization tremendously. How? When these specifically the wage on code 2019 will be implemented, so the minimum fine for a single non-fulfillment of obligation, it will be imposed 20,000 rupees, and maximum it can go for the 50,000 rupees. If there are the five number of the obligation that non-fulfilled obligation imposed by the agency or the authorities on the employer, so what will be the fine actually in amount imposed to the employer? So it will be around 2 lakh rupees and 50,000 rupees to the employer. However, the provision of the imprisonment has been removed related to these law or the existing act which regulate define the wages. But the financially it is going to be impacted tremendously the organization and its businesses. Labor code which has been enacted, that is the Industrial Relation Code 2020. So there are the different existing law which has been merged under the provision of the Industrial Relation Code 2020. So as per the existing labor law, the Industrial Employment Standing Order, the Industrial Dispute Act and the Trade Union Act, so there are the minimum provision of the fine is 100 rupees only, and maximum it can be go up till 5,000 rupees. And however, the imprisonment provision are not there. When the new Industrial Relation Code 2020 will be implemented, that what is going to be changed in the future? The fine which was only 100 rupees for any non-fulfilled obligation for the employer, that has been increased for 50,000 rupees minimum and maximum 2 lakh rupees. Now imagine, as of now, the organization and the people who are dealing with the level of compliances, they consider that it is just making off the record. But in the future, it is impacting the organization too much, and then the pain point of your employer is going to be growing, blasting them when it is impacting their financial, because they are the people, business oriented and financial oriented people, because the business has been set up or business has been coming specifically for making the profit. So that will impact them financially. Now, there are the practices within the organization too. Complying on the document, not on the ground. There are some practices available in the organization. We have practically seen that there are some packet system available, because as of now, with the existing labor law, there are the only fine can be imposed for the 5,000 rupees. So if you are paying 2,000 rupees to the inspector, so your compliance will be black and white complied. But further, when this new code will be implemented, when any employer or any inspector visit to your organization and impose the certain non-conformity and non-fulfillment of the compliance, so they will impose on the 10 lakh rupees of fine on your organization. So in that case, if you are settling with that inspector, how much that will be asked? He will be asked you 15 lakh rupees. Your employer will never allow you. He will kick out you from the organization immediately. That's why you need to be prepared and be ready for this future implementation of the new labor laws. It is not that it will be repealed, but it will be sure implemented from the new financial year. However, under the existing labor law, which has been merged under the Industrial Relations Code 2020, there is no provision of the imprisonment. But in the new code on the industrial relation, there is the provision of the imprisonment for 1 year has been incorporated. When you are not ready to making the fine, so there are also the provision of the imprisonment for the employer too. Other two codes we have covered related to the wage and the industrial relation. So there are the third code is related to the Social Security 2020. In the Social Security Act or the Social Security Code 2020, there are the different 8 or 9 types of existing labor law which has been merged under the Social Security Code. So if we see with the existing labor law, for the non-fulfillment of any obligation, so the minimum fine which can be imposed to an employer, that is 500 rupees only, and maximum it can go up till 20,000 rupees. However, the imprisonment is there from minimum 3 months to maximum 3 years. When the Social Security Code 2020 will be implemented, that the provision for non-fulfillment of the fine which can be imposed on an employer, that is minimum 50,000 rupees and maximum 1 lakh rupees. So it will also impact it. If you imagine, for example, there is a 5 non-conformity or non-fulfillment of compliances, so it will be directly the 5 lakh rupees impact on your organization. Further, the imprisonment for the 10 years to the employer. And further, there is the fourth labor code, the code on occupational safety, health and working condition code 2020. So there are the different existing labor law which regulate the condition of employment as well as the occupational safety health in the organization. So that has been merged under the provision or under the occupational safety, health and working condition code 2020. If you see which are the existing labor law has been merged under the provision of the specifically the occupational safety, health and working condition code 2020. So there is the provision of the fines for non-fulfillment of the obligations, that is minimum 500 rupees and maximum 1 lakh rupees. And the provision of the imprisonment under the different condition of the existing labor law, it is minimum 3 months and maximum 2 years. But when this new code on the health and safety working condition will be implemented. So there, the provision for the fine has been tremendously changed. So that is, for any non-fulfillment of the obligation by the employer, the minimum fine will be imposed to an employer 50,000 rupees, or maximum it can be go up to 5 lakh rupees for specifically the factories or manufacturing entities, because 60% of the industry in Indian state and the Indian continent that are the manufacturing. So when the fine will be imposed for a single non-fulfillment of the obligation, that is 5 lakh rupees. If there are the 5 number of the non-compliance or non-conformity, non-fulfillment of the obligation which has been defined or prescribed under the Occupational Safety, Health and Working Condition Code 2020, it will impact in the 5 minutes to an employer 25 lakh rupees. So 25 lakh rupees is a salary of a senior manager level people in the organization. And there also, however, the imprisonment provision has been a little bit relaxed, but it has been made straight up till the 2 years. Now there is a condition of the month has been removed. It will be imposed for the 2 years. So these are the 4 different existing labor law which are going to be implemented from the new financial year. So for that, you need to be prepared, ready with these new obligations and new pain for your employer. How you can assure that? I will share that in the next section. But further, when we just accumulate these 4 new codes and what you need to be do as a preparedness and readiness for these 4 new code implementation. So here we have specifically prepared a representation for you what you need to be do. When the law are coming and their condition considering related to the labor dispute as well as the issues in the organization that is connected with the wages specifically. So when we accumulated all the provision and it's highlighted the certain provision which are mandatory, you need to be considered while these new codes will be implemented and you need to be prepared and be ready for that. So there are the different type of the points come out and which you can also consider as the reforms, but that are some bigger obligation for the employer which can impact them and increase their pain point again. So that are the specifically one of the reform which we can consider as a change, that is the changes in the definition of the wage. However, as per the existing labor law which applies to the different industries, so there are the, when we accumulate that, so it come that the 16 types of different definition has been provided for the wages. But one of the reform which we can consider that under the provision of the new labor codes, the definition of wage has been given as one unified or uniform definition, that with the considering of all the that the new labor code. So the definition for the wage now, it will be the basic dearness and the retaining allowances, whatever you are giving that. And secondly, for the provision of considering the different law, it will be the 50% of the total wages you are paying to them. Earlier, in the existing labor law, there are the some condition related to the basic wage, some are the gross wage, and the total salary wage is required to be calculated. And one of the important reform which we can consider that every obligation which are considering or coming in the preview of the relation and that calculating or considering the labor law, so that is the unified as the basic wage, and every calculation related to the law when these 4 codes will be implemented or specifically related to the industrial issues or industrial dispute, so it will be calculated based on the basic wage now. But further, the basic wage has been defined, it should be 50% of your total wages. When it comes to in the purview of the wages in consideration of the law, it is not your corporate term, the cost to company. It is the your gross salary you are paying to them. So that's why it has been divided in the 3 components, the definition of the basic pay, DNS allowances, and retirement. Retirement are the mandatory component but not considered for the wage specific which you are regulating as the law consideration. So it will be the directly the gross wages you are paying to them, and your basic wage should be 50% of your gross wages now when these four new codes will be implemented. When this concept will be implemented, that 50% of the basic wage of your gross wage, then it will impact financially the employer as well as the employee. How? When the wage will be, basic wage will be 50% of the wage, and every, as of now, the every contribution which you are paying, that will be calculated based on the basic wage, and the calculation system will be same, and the basic wage will be 50% of the gross wage, so it will be automatically impact the or increase the cost for the employer. And further, when it is on the, when the basic wage is 50% and when the contribution for the different remittances or the different social security code will be deducted, so it will also impact the income of the employee and their take home salary will be reduced. So furthermore, it is also provided the separate definition for the worker and the employee. However, as per the existing law, there was no definition for the employee. Employee is the terminology of the corporate. But in the new codes, the different definition was given for worker as well as the employee. And there is one new concept which has been applied. So that is the floor wage concept. And based on that floor wage concept, the minimum wage will be defined or prescribed by the state specific. And every 5 years, the central government will revise that the floor wages. Then there are also defined the definition for contractor and the contract labor. Then provision related to the period of payment that has been revised, it has been made equal to all by 7th of the preceding month. You need to be assured the payment for every employee. Then the provision which we have discussed for the certifying standing order for the factory specific, it has been increased for the 300 number. However, as for the existing labor law or the labor act, specifically the Industrial Establishment Standing Order Act 1946, it is 100 numbers. Similarly, for the every organization there, you need to be facilitate the grievance redress committee when there are 20 or more workers you are engaging in any proceeding, any day in the proceeding 12 months, it will become applicable for you. And now there are the one relaxation for you, the labor inspector, which come to you as of the inspector and imposing only the fines and not only directing to you to do, but they will now working as the aggregator and facilitator. First, give you the guideline, then assuring that you have to follow all the provisions. However, the compliance part and maintaining of the record will be remain same. So then the related to the gratuity, so it has been also provided the provision, the eligibility for the gratuity, claiming of gratuity. However, it is the right, the statutory right of the employee, but the period has been reduced for the 3 years. And there is one additional obligation which has been made mandatory for the employer. There the you need to be facilitate the free annual checkup of for every employee of your organization free of cost. Then the condition separately for related to the leave management has been revised and reformed. However, earlier there the organization was less, that there are the three types of different leaves you are providing, that which is known as the casual leave, sick leave and the earned leave. However, earlier that the casual leave and sick leaves, that if not availed by the workman, that will be, or employee, that will be lapse for the further year. But now the condition has been incorporated that the casual leave and sick leave will also be carried forward for the next year and accumulated till then 30 numbers, and then after you have to encash them. And furthermore, the employment of women has been accepted within the time of the beyond 7 p.m. and before the 6 a.m. But you need to be assured their safety and security and commuting properly to their home place, to their workplace, and workplace to the home place. And further, the now it has been also conditioned when you are engaging any workman or employee on the overtime, you need to be take a consent of them, or it is needed. Mandatory to you need to be pay double of their wages to them. So these are the main certain provision provided under the provision which we have making the crux or the changes which are going to be changed as a first scenario. For that you need to be ready and need to be prepared for implementation of these new provision of the four new codes. So furthermore, here we have also prepared one representation for you, what you have to do. First, the scenario when it comes to the minimum or specifically the perspective of the wage. So when the concept of the end of basic wage will be applied, so what you need to be assured and what will be happen for your organization, how you will apply that concept in your organization, and what you need to be do when you have to restructure your organization. So here is one representation for you, which you can utilize in your organization to restructuring and complying with the condition of the existing labor law. So there is specifically, as for the existing labor law or the minimum wage act, the minimum wage have the certain component. One is the basic wage, which has defined, and further the dearness allowances, or which has been revised every 6 months by the state. Then the total minimum wage is the, for example, 12,000. It is different in the different state. This is the definition for the minimum wage as of now with the existing Minimum Wage Act 1948. Then in the scenario when the new code will be implemented and the different types of the provision you need to be facilitate, so in that case what you have to do for assuring of the compliance under the different provision of the new code. So if you see in the scenario of the provident fund, as for the existing provision, so what you are doing and as of now, so there it is provided, if however in the EPFO there is the capping of the 50,000 rupees. And the component, if the minimum wage is 8,000, you have to keep it that. Then after the additional amount which you are paying to them, that is the 4,000 in the total, your minimum wage or your wage which you are paying to an employee, that is 12,000 rupees. And the contribution for the EPFO, that is going to be deducted on the basic wage. So it will be in that cost to you 960 rupees. And when it is going to be case of the, you have to consider the minimum wage as the basic wage, or it should be below the capping, then it will be cost you for the 1440 rupees. And the second scenario, if you see some, there are some supervisory people whose salary will be around 20,000, you have the different component in that salary. So the minimum wage you can consider as the basic wage, then you are providing the house rent and commencing and washing. So the total wages, which is considered the wages, is here the gross wage. And as for the condition and the capping of the 15,000 rupees, you need to pay the 1800 rupees of contribution in the EPFO. But when it is the basic wage will be 50% of the total wage, and the minimum wage is specifically, if you consider, is the 12,000 rupees. So with the condition of the new code or the wage code, the contribution you need to be deduct for the employees, it will be 1440 rupees. So it means it will reduce the condition, or it will reduce the cost for the employer and impact there. But in the case of the lower wages employee, it will impact financially too much for the organization. Similarly, in the case, if you see in the scenario three, there is the, there are 24,000 of the gross salary, and the 50% is 12,000, and it is, you are complying with the condition of the basic wage, which should be 50% of the wage specifically. So in that case, the, as per the 50% of basic, where the contribution will be calculated, that will be on the basic wage, and that case you need to be pay only the 1440 rupees. And if you are engaging the international worker in the organization, and in that case, as per the existing condition for the contribution of EPFO, you need to be deduct it on the whole wages or salary you are paying to them. But when the new code will be implemented and the condition for the basic wage should be 50% of the gross wage, so the contribution for the international worker will reduce for the half, near about half or more than half of that, but it will also save the money of the employer. Then similarly, as per the provident fund and then further the gratuity provision, so what will be happen when this concept of the 50% of wage will be increased, of the wage of the 50% will be increased, so in that case the gratuity part will be decreased for increased again. As for the existing law, it will be calculated on the basic wages, and that in the case of if you are paying the 28,500 rupees, and for the new concept, it will be the minimum wage of the 14,000 rupees and 250 rupees, and that need to be calculated on that base. So the gratuity will be increased, or gratuity amount will be increased for the employer. Similarly, if there are the retrenchment, closure, that the compensation in the industrial relation, as of now, with the existing compensation act or the ID Act, specifically 1946-47, the compensation will be calculated on the gross salary. When the new concept will be implemented and consideration with the four new codes, it will be the 50% of the gross salary, and then it will also provided the relaxation to the employer. Specifically, when the minimum wage, as per the Factories Act, it is the, you need to be considered the minimum wage as basic wage. But further, when the concept of the occupational or the 50% will be implemented, so it we should be the 14,025 rupees, means the 50% of your gross salary should be as basic salary with DA to your employee. Similarly, so there are the provision, you need to have a structure of the tax friendly to all those employees who are coming in the provision of the tax. So for that, we have provided the concept for you how you can calculate that. So this is the template which will be received to you for your personal references and uses and for your learning. So you will get all these documents becoming ready and preparing for the implementation of the provision of these new codes. So this was all about the section one, and in this section one, we have covered the present issue with the existing labor law and further the perspective of the new labor codes and when that are going to be changed, that are going to be implemented, and how they are changing the scenario of the working condition in the organization and the compliance system, and how, what are the, it will tremendously becoming more impactful and the paining for the employer. So now it is coming to that the professional, the HR professional who are dealing with the compliances and the service provider, they need to be assured that all the provision of the new changes that can be implemented with system in the organization, and how you can assure the provision so that it can, you can help the organization to making their, to becoming their businesses interrupted, and then their image damage, as well as their impact on the their financial condition. So here in the second, we are going to be learn the practically how you can develop these four success quality of a labor law administrative, and then further this how that will become a career USP for your future succession as a HR professional as well as the labor law compliance service provider. So let's begin with here. Section second, we are going to be practically implement the statutory compliance or labor law compliance management portfolio in your organization, how you systematically can implement the provision or assuring the compliance in your organization so that you can assure the appropriate compliance in your organization and save your employer from the impact which we have discussed in the previous, so the first section. And similarly, and further, these, this system which we, I'm sharing with you, that will also help you to create this USP and learn and develop these four skills of success skill of the labor law compliance administration as well as the specialist, that becoming more vigilant, foresighted, accountable and responsible. So first of all, we have divided this labor law compliance, the statutory compliance management portfolio in three different pillars. And those three different pillars are, first, we need to understand the structure, how the compliance will be implemented, what is their structure, so that we can understand it properly. And then we can implement it easily in organization to assuring every requirement and facilitating them in organization. Because in the future, the compliance part or assuring the compliance or regulation of the compliance going to be very much impactful for the organization. Here, first, what you have to do, so there first understand the compliances have the three layer of structure. First, it is required the certain approvals. Then when you obtain the approvals under the applies or applicable labor law, so then after it will be granted to you based on certain conditions. And those conditions you need to be fulfilled in your organization and facilitate that. And for that, you need to be maintain the different records. When you are fulfilling that, all the requirement which has been prescribed in that condition and which is conditioned for you to make facilitation that, then you have to maintain the record for that. When you are maintaining the records, then you need to be assured that, or you need to be share those compliance or facilitating of the provision with the authorities who are regulating and monitor these provision in the organization as per the certification or the approval you have obtained for commencing your businesses. So that you need to be periodically submit certain records to them in forms of different returns or remittances. So let's understand this, what you have to do that. Here I'm sharing with you one biggest template which that will help you to make more vigilant and the more force. You need to be prepared a unique master compliance calendar which will help you to make you more vigilant, so that I'm sharing it here with you. How you have to implement that, it is ready to use, but you have to change as per your organization scenario if there are the different law applied to your organization. As I've shared with you, so you need to understand the structure of the level of compliances. There is the approval, then you required it that they maintain a certain record, and then you need to be submit the that periodical compliances with the agencies for assuring that compliancing all the condition that has been prescribed in the condition of particular approval that has been granted to you for commencing of the business. So accordingly, as I mentioned that in the beginning, we will pick up for the example as the manufacturing setup. And in that manufacturing setup, there are the different types of approval you need to be obtained. So there, the manufacturing, they have the factory, so you require the factory license. Then there are the processes available which have the pollution related consent you require to be follow the procedure related to the pollution and the consent under the water and air consent. Then the you first commencing of the business, you need to be get approval of the building plan for that particular premises, and then you need to be obtain the non-objection certificate for the fire and safety, then the provision of your registration related to the employee state insurance as well as the employer provident fund. Then there are the registration required if you are engaging the contractor labor as well as the outsourcing manpower. You need to be get registration under the Contract Labor Act 1917, and then after the premises is on lease, so that you need to be follow and make the assure all that provision when it comes to the different types of the approval for the manufacturing. It is not the manufacturing, it is broadly covered because the maximum number of the existing labor law applies to the factory. So that's why we are exemplifying it. If you are working in the other industries, which are the shop and commerce and other, but the same scenario will be fitted to that, you can implement at it as is it. And then further, the different types of the records you need to be maintained, however, as per the provision of the factories. So how many records and register required there, we have incorporated that here near about the 27 number of the different records you have to maintain. So their frequency, we have specifically prescribed who will be the concerned person for that. Accordingly, you have to be incorporate that. Then further, different types of the display required. And that is the one-time activity, and somewhere you need to be updated to the frequency. We have defined it here, so that you need to be just implement that and monitor it. When you implementing this master calendar or the master template in your organization, the best way is to you can print it on the 5A page and then paste it on your desk, and where it will provide you the making you vigilant and foresighted. What is going to be next? Then there are the different types of record you need to be submit periodically. What are the applicable or applied law or existing level of for the factory specifically? So different types of the records you have to submit, their frequency, their time, the concern. Then you can update it as on time so that you can assure every compliance. The due date as well as the frequency, you can decide it according to you. It should be as per the governmental due date before so that you can assure it to the organization. So this template will be reached to you. You have to just modify something in that, and then you can paste this at your desktop, and where it will help you to become the vigilant and foresighted in or for the complying with the regulation of the factories as well as the your organization wherever you are working, even that are covering under the factories as well as the Shop and Commercial Establishment Act. So this template will be reached to you as it is for your references and for your future working. So let's begin with. So this is all about the mandatory, the master plan or master calendar for your compliance management in your organization, which will make you the vigilant and foresighted. So that you need to be utilized for complying every requirement in your organization related to the applicable labor law. So this is, you have understand about the structure, what is it, how you have to implement it so that it will become easy for you to understanding as well as implementing. So this is the first pillar of the statutory compliance management portfolio, and that the template we have provided with you, you just have to modify little bit what is the change required as per the state specific, and further how you have to reach to this level of that compliance master template as well as the calendar, how you can reach to that. There you need to be a definitely or a specific process. Without following of the process, you can reach to that and assuring the desired compliances as well as which is required under the provision of the act or the different act, however, that is as per the new labor code which are going to be implemented very soon. So that will be required a specific process. How you have to reach to this level of the defining of this particular, that the master template for your organization, which will make you the more vigilant and foresighted, so that you need to be follow specifically the three layer of process. So that is, one is your internal process, which you can develop by yourself, but you require to be help from the other people also, how you have to engage that formulation I'm sharing with you. Then you have to go with the agency's compliance. Agency, it may be two types. One is you are engaging the agency from outside, and that the service provider. And the second one, there are the agencies, specifically the vendors you are engaging for deployment of the contractual manpower. And third one is specifically, mostly in the organization, which we have seen 90% of the organization, the compliances are complied for the presenting to the management, not for the requirement of the regulation provided in the law specifically and the authorities who are regulating these laws. So here we will also share with you how you can implement this level of compliances management portfolio in your organization when you have to assure the compliances related to the provision and specifically for the authorities and the regulatory perspective, not for your employer. Your employer will be automatically impressed when you develop this concept in your organization. So before that, how you reach to these three layer of structure. So here I'm sharing with you one of the broad master template which we have prepared for you to making it easy for you to implement in your of becoming helpful to you assuring the compliance in your organization and making it more compliant and having redeveloping and rebuilding that credibility in your organization when you are applying this concept in your organization from tomorrow when you are resuming back to your office for your daily jobs. So this is one of the master template and we prepared where we have covered more than 33 number of the existing labor law which applied to the variety of the organization. However, we have considered it here the manufacturing, because in the manufacturing industries the maximum number of the existing labor law applied. So there we have specifically helping you what you have to do. When you have go to the go for the process of your assuring the compliance and developing that level of compliance management portfolio in your organization. So further that, you need to be assured that what is exactly required for your organization under the consideration of the law, and what you need to be assured, how you can check that it is compliance, it is as per the requirement, and what you need to be do. So this is the master template which are going to be help you as per the different existing level of like factories, then the contract labor, then other the industrial employment standing order, and then the industrial dispute act and the contract labor act. There are the near about 27 of the existing labor law which we have covered in this master template for you. Just you have to utilize this master checklist or the template as considering your organization, is that applicable in your organization or not. So there is the, as per the different sections which is applicable to your organization and the government agencies and authorities, when they will comply and then they will inspect your organization, so it will be based on these sections which are applicable to your organization. So it is helping to you that you just have to check out the sections we have provided, what will be applicable for the factories specifically. So you just have to check out it is compliant or not. If it is compliant, it is okay. If it is not compliant, and when you need to be comply it, for that you need to be follow the three layer of the structure. And then after, you can also utilize this, you can define the concerned department and the concerned person who will provide such documents, some data to you, and their frequency, and what is required, when it is required to be finished, and then further, if it is required to be submit, and what are your actions as of now. That will be, this master template will help you to implement the compliance in your organization, specifically inspect your organization. Assess your organization, the existing status of your organization, for in the provision of the existing labor law, is it compliant or not. This master checklist will define, and you will utilize it as it is, because we are going to be provide it to you as same as is it, so you can implement it in your organization to assessing the norms of your organization as per the complying under the provision of the how you have to reach the level which we have shared in the three layer of structure, and that master calendar which will make you the vigilant, foresighted, and further this, when you are auditing or when you are inspecting as well as assessing your organization with this master template, that will make you more accountable for the provision of the different labor laws, and further the different labor laws, its provision coming with the four new labor codes. So now what you have to do, as here I have shared with you the three layers of the labor law compliance management, or compliance, specifically compliance management process. So first, when you go with the assessing of your organization with that master template which we have shared, that there may be a certain area if that are the compliant with, so you do not have to do anything for that. But further, which are the area non-compliant, so for that you need to be monitor that. So how you have to monitor that? So here the first process, or your process, the first layer coming out for you, that you need to be monitor all those points which are not complying. So for that you need to be follow up internal compliance procedure, which I'm sharing with you here right away. For the open point or the uncompliant area of your establishment, your organization, that you need to be incorporate here as per the different act, and that is your factory. So under the factory, what is non-compliant, you need to be incorporate that here. However, we have defined this template for basically applying the procedure for assuring compliance in your organization, so that as per the required, in which month that is required, and what is the due date for that, even the governmental, and where you are submitting that, where you are required that, or you can decide it internally for you, so that you can assure every compliances before their due date. And one thing you need to be considered, mostly the organization, we have seen that they consider the due date that they have to submit, or they have to, if they are registered sending such compliance through the register post, that should be go from your organization on that same day. But it is wrong. It is non-compliance. Everything which has defined the due date, it means it should be reached and accepted by the authority on that particular day or before that particular day. So that will be clearly compliant. So what you have to do and how you have to utilize this template, and there you need to be defined the monthly basis when you are complying these uncompliant portion as well as the uncompliant statutory requirement in your organization. That you have to define the plan in the beginning, then you have to keep a separate portion. However, we have incorporated that, you just have to monitor it. Whatever is the non-compliance portion is there, you need to be incorporate in that. Then after, you need to be put the plan for there and then monitor. Then when you have to complete it, that when you have to mark it. So it will make you more accountable, that you are assuring it will, you are developing a system in your organization that will assure automatically your compliance in the organization, so that you do not have to be hurried. Mostly in the organization, we have seen that the organization, when there is the notice come for the inspection, they start making the records, then they try to make certain provision in the organization. So when the compliance come, when the inspection come, there the compliance will be totally failed, and those people who are responsible for ensuring the compliance, that will be kicked out by the organization. Because in the beginning, they have assured and they have confirmed that their management, that the compliance is fully compliant. But when practically it come to the ground, then the compliance is zero. On the ground, it is zero. So that's why when you are implementing this system, your compliance will never be failed. Why I'm saying it, that I'm sharing it in the next, and this template will reach to you as it is for implementation and the assessing your internal organizational data status, as well as monitoring the non-compliant stature, and then comply that within the time limit you have to decide utilizing this template. And one another thing, when you have to assure the compliance in your organization, even that is the going to be the exist new labor laws or the labor code which are going to become, there are the new perspective come, that time you can also utilize these templates. But further, you need to just make the changes of the due dates. And then it come to the second layer, or in the first layer one part is there. One suggestion is for you, when you are going to be implement the labor law compliance management portfolio, so you need to be assured, you need to be develop or constitute a committee of compliance. So there should be some HOD people there, so they can give you the third party viewpoint when you are going to be assess your organization, as the template we have provided and the existing condition of your organization in regard to the different applicable labor law which are applied, different existing labor law which are applied to your organization. Then in the second layer, what you have to do, that as per the Contract Labor Act, when you are hiring any agency, specifically the Contract Labor Act, you are engaging the contract manpower. So for that, you need to be assured. The principal employer is responsible for assuring of the compliance under the Contract Labor Act for the contractors too. So how you need to be assured, that we have also designed one template for that. This template will also be used by the agencies. Like if you are the service provider for your client or the corporates, you are providing the services, so you can utilize this template to auditing or assessing the status of the organization based on the requirement, whatever is there. So one, the first, the master checklist we have shared with, it is applicable for the every organization. But now role is changed. If the HR professional who are already the employee of the organization, they are doing it, and that in case you can do it that for your internal as well as for your vendors. If the organization somewhere they have outsourced the compliance procedure and the compliance for the organization, so that a service provider can also utilize this procedure. But when you are going back tomorrow to the your organization, definitely you will kick out your service provider, because I'm providing with you the system that you can implement in your organization very soon, and that will also help you. Will also save the money of your organization or your employer, and furthermore it will also help you to rebuild your credibility to assuring the compliance in your organization. So now I'm sharing it with you, the template, how you have to utilize this template in your organization and how it will help you to comply with the provision of the labor laws, even that are the existing and coming in the future. So that will also help you. So this is specifically the template we have prepared for the agencies. However, it is referring specifically related to the contract. We have considered it for the internal employee, which are the HR people who are dealing with the compliances. So on that part, you need to be assessed or you need to be audited. Inspect your agencies or the vendors. What are the definitely required provision of the contract labor and the connecting labor law for that agencies, so that you need to be assessed or evaluate that. So you can utilize this template. So what is required? We have already incorporated what is the due, the required document there. And here you will incorporate the status, then the different types of findings, which you find after assessing of your vendor or your client. So that finding, and then further there your next action. So when that action will be come here, what you have to do, then you have to utilize the first template for the, or you have to share that first template with them so that they can incorporate the plan or execution in that, and then they will also monitor and fulfill all that documents. And one important thing which you need to be considered while going for the agencies, even that is for your employer on or for the vendor, so adopt the process of the quarterly assessment of their of your vendor specifically, so that you can assure the compliance as soon as possible to comply with the all regulation and assuring the compliance of your organization. So this is the template which will be reached to you as it is for your implementation and your utilization, and that is for your personal custody. You can utilize it as it is. Then it was the second layer of the process when you have to assess or evaluate the your agencies, your vendors. Then it come to the further for the organization now, the third layer. So that is the one of the important layer, the compliance specifically based on for this specifically the layer, or as well as the you have to comply for the agencies as well as the authority who are regulating and monitoring that. When you implement the concept or as well as the formulation, I'm sharing with you the statutory compliance management portfolio. This is originally developed for the keeping in mind the compliance assured or monitored, regulated by the agencies who are appointed for regulating the provision of the law. So that's why here we have arranged one tool for you, which will help you to work one step ahead to the agencies also. And when you implementing this whole process, you will also ask the question and counter the agencies when they giving any non-conformity or the unfulfilled obligation to the organization. You will also counter to them why is that it will be as it is and it should be and you have complied it. So here one that tool we have arranged from the internal processes of the government agencies. When you implement, and this concept we have designed based on this particular tool, so that you can assure the 100 process compliance. If that agency people come to you and giving you the non-conformity for you did not compliant with the regulation of the provision which we have shared in the master checklist, which will be applicable for the industry specifically or manufacturing, so you can counter to them what you have to do and what you have to specifically do. So this is the one of the internal process of the government. However, it is from the Haryana specific state, so it is applicable for the every state also, but you can arrange it from that particular state or not, I don't know, but here we have arranged it. It is the same system in every state. So how they conduct their inspection for the organization, so which is periodically, what they keep in mind and what is their procedure. When you implement this procedure in your organization, you will definitely assure 100% compliance in your organization. And further, the first checklist We have shared with you in the template where we have specifically covered all the existing labor law which apply to the factories, so that we have specifically prepared for you based on this tool, so that you can assure without efforts in your organization when there you do not have to ask to anyone to go to some consultant, that just we are going to be implement the labor law compliance system in your organization, so they will help you. Now it will assure you to you can implement it by yourself because we are providing you the system. So the first we I have shared with you the template, so that template where we have provided you the tool that you have to assess or audit your organization as the existing status of your organization in respect of the different regulation and compliances under the different labor law. So that master template we have prepared on this internal process of the agency. So it is the like different act, which is the section for the requirement specifically or the regulation and the different rule which has been provided under the rule of that specific law. So we have covered that what it need to be there. So based on that we have prepared that template for you for your easy understanding and specifically for using and implementation. So understanding it has been done here in this live session today. Now you have to implement it so you can utilize that template. So that is based on that. Here it has been provided all the provision, how it will be assessed and what are the section and then the rules. So you need to be understand also when you have to, if you have to become a specialist in the labor law compliance, so you need to be understand that the every law or the labor law specifically, they have two different parts. One is the law itself and second one is their rule. So like if you are working as an HR professional in your organization, you have the HR policies. So first one is the policy. So policy is specifically you have to achieve an objective. You have to facilitate something to your employee and that is the objective of that policy. Then there are the defined long procedure, how that will be achieved. So that is the process. Similarly in the law, one is the law, which is the objective of implementing the three major objectives. So that is the health, welfare, and safety, and how that has been achieved with the different existing labor law. So there are the different rule provided. However, there are the central rule, and accordingly, the central rule have the references for the state specific rule. They can change something. However, in the state rule, there are not some biggest changes from, or that are not the big difference between the state rules as well as the central rule. So if you can imagine or you can think that there are only the small changes in the state rule. One is the fee which you are paying to be for registration. So that will be different in the state to state. And other, the records you are maintaining, their formats, that will be submitted later and their form number will be different. Otherwise, the information the state are collecting, so that are the same. These are the small changes in the different state provision related to the labor laws, otherwise it will be same. So this you can implement this procedure. However, the master template based on this internal procedure of the agency, we have implemented it, and further it will help you to assure the 100% compliances. And further, if you utilize this system in your organization, implement it, you will definitely encounter with the agencies if they give you the non-conformity. So this checklist and the tool will reach to you. You can utilize it. You can thoroughly read it. There are the 1,000 procedures given, which will help you in the every corner of Indian state where you are working for your organization. It has 25 pages and it has provided every small aspect related to the assuring of compliances in your organization. With the next one. So this is the second pillar of the labor statutory compliance management portfolio with the present issues as well as the future perspective. You can utilize it for the futures also. This system will give you the foolproofing assurance of the compliance management in your organization, where you have to follow the three layer of the compliance management process in your organization. When you implement this procedure in your organization, that will make you be more accountable and more responsible. Credibility, which has been that considered for the HR section as the non-functional, as the non-profit, or only the inspecting or the policing function for related to the discipline maintaining. But when it comes to the level of compliance, it is considered the non-functional job by the professional itself. So that's why most of the professional who are working as the compliance specialist, they failed, and in the maximum 98% of the organization, compliance cannot be fully assured. The compliance part is becoming more impactful and very terrific for the organization, where it is impacting the cost directly to the employer. However, as per the existing the practices organization following to paying something tacky to the inspecting authority. But because there is a reason they can accept that, because for any non-conformity, the fine is only 100 rupees or 500 rupees. If you pay the 2000 rupees to any inspector, so he will be okay. So that 500 paying to the government, he is getting the 2000. So that's why he is making assuring your compliances in the paper as compliant, but practically it is not. But now in the future, you need to be assured it at ground. So otherwise, it will impact your organization. When the organization will be impacted, so finally impact will be on the people who are assuring the compliances. And when you implement this concept, it will also help you to rebuild your credibility in the organization as an individual, then as a department, that will also assure that the concept of the HRBP also, where you have to consider specifically the costing of the organization, and that costing will also come in the part of the compliance. Now in the future, the compliance part is becoming a great job for the HR professional and very progressive job. So now in the third pillar, when you have implemented that, yes, in the practically in the organization, we have seen that many organizations that the people who are dealing with the compliance specifically, what do? They just convey their management, the every compliances has been done and it is fully compliant. When on the ground there are the inspection, then the compliance is zero, and that particular people who are working as taking care of the compliance part, they will be kicked out. Or otherwise the organization, they engage the outside agencies for the statutory compliances, and they are paying them to a too big amount because they have the dealing with the agencies. So they are paying to them regularly. So that's why your compliance is assured. However, the agencies people, they are not assuring the compliance fully. However, one or two time in the month, they will visit to your organization, but the records, you have to maintain that. When you have to do that job, they just coming to and just visiting for 2 and 3 hours in your organization, you are paying them the wages more than you. So why you cannot do it by yourself when the system have shared with you? So now the third step is the reporting. How you have to report your working. When you implement this system, you do not have to report anything to your that management. It will be reported by yourself, but you have to follow this system. So what you have to do for the reportings now, so I'm sharing it with you, that will help you to making your reporting impressive in front of your management, because the management people, they are the business oriented people. They don't have time to spend with you to understand that your organization is compliance with or not complying fully. So here I'm sharing with you just one pager template which you have to utilize to reporting the compliance status to your management. So this is just one pager that it is divided as per the structure of the labor law compliance portfolio which we have shared with you in the first pillar. So the approval, what are the approval for your organization required and you have obtained, then the different types of record you have to maintain, and further the different type of records you are maintaining and then submitting on time in the form of returns. If you are managing the different location, you can incorporate it here differently than the status of the compliance at these different locations, and then further countermeasure whatever that. So you need to be incorporate in that in this template, and you just have to share that within 5 to 10 minutes your status of compliance will be shared, or even that you can also utilize it for your other organization sharing also, so that it will also help you to strategically spending time for the sharing of the status of your working within 5 minutes if they ask the question. So in the background you need to be prepared something, so that is also prepared for you, so you do not have to do something extra from your side. So that you just have to implement, or whatever there in your organization, you just have to incorporate that in this template, and that will help you to sharing with your organization immediately. Within 10 to 15 minutes, you can also make the incorporation of some changes in that. So that are the approval which we have discussed in the first part one. Then the different types of the returns required, and that their period, which is compliance, and specifically the time where you are sharing and up till it is updated, and the current month. Then the different types of record, so that you need to be facilitate and you are maintaining in the organization. So that it is only when they ask, you have to share it, or otherwise you just have to share in this template, and it will assure that your credibility and confidence on you by your employer. And in the first layer, then the second layer, where we have that periodically and occasionally or quarterly, annually, where you have to submit it. So it is the similar. But further, we have also prepared for you one dashboard, which is providing the information and knowledge related to the different labor laws, which require to be assured by the organization. So that we have covered more around 33 number of the existing labor law, which providing the different provision for the organization, so that you do not have to go somewhere to assuring of the compliances. And that here we have around existing labor law, more than 19 labor law, where we have provided in the every provision, what you have to assure, which type of the rules are there, what is the frequency, who will be the authority, when you have to submit. So everything for your understanding for the different labor law that we have incorporated it for your understanding and implementation. So that dashboard will be reached to you as it is for your utilization and implementation in your organization. How you have to report with your management that the compliances you have assured. So when you implement this concept, it doesn't that you do not have to share it by yourself or impress your management that you have done this thing. This system will work itself. You have developed a system, and this system is working if you implement that as it is. I have shared with you all those templates. I have shared it here, that will be reached to you as it is. This the three, the labor law compliance management portfolio have the three different pillars, where you have understand about the three layer of the structure, then the three layer of process, and two layer of the reporting. So this was all about the section first and section two, and now come and welcome you in the section three, and section three specifically the question and answer. So you can keep your question and answer ready here. And but before going into the question answer, so here I have something to share with you for becoming the labor law compliance specialist. So here I will take only 4 to 5 minutes to complete this sharing with you. So here you have learned about the labor law compliance administrative part, how you have to reach to the labor. But practically, when you have to go, it required the deep understanding and going into the deep practices for assuring the compliance part and becoming the specialist in the labor law compliance. So for that, we have one upper level or second level of the labor law compliance specialist program, specifically for 30-day masteries, where, and that program, this program is designed with the objective of the where developing the four essential skills for the labor law compliance people who are dealing with the, making you more vigilant, foresighted, accountable, and responsible, and further enhancing your career as the labor law compliance specialist. And this program is designed specifically to having some takeaway, so there you will be get the 30 live sessions, which will be based on the practical learning on the different existing labor law for the different industrial perspective. When and then after, you will get the access to the all video recordings which we have live for the lifetime. And when this live session will be completed, after that there will be 2 live session in a month with all those participants which has been gone through this mastery program. So it means this program is just not a one-time learning, it is a hand-holding program where we will provide you support in your day-to-day working, where you will be helped, and that you will have find any issue to implementation or dealing with the compliances. So in that 2 live session monthly, there we will be cover up the new update related to the labor law as well as your issues at your work front. Then after, whatever the live document we will design, a standardized document that will be provided with you lively for your personal custody. And then after, this will be the certified that the completion, that certification program, and you will provided with a completion certificate on this program. So specifically what this program is exactly, as I mentioned that it is a hand holding coaching program, and there it will be a weekend program, and every Saturday and Sunday this program will be live executive for you, and there will be the 2 hours of practical learning and 30 minutes of question and answer. So it will be 2.5 hours every Saturday and Sunday, which will start by 8 p.m. So further, what we are covering in that, so there will be the flow, how it will be started. So there will be 30-minute overview of the act which we are covering, one act, one day. So it is the practically overview of the act specifically. Then how you have to proceed with how you to obtain the operable maintaining of the record, when what are the document required, even that are online or offline, that we will be define and learn and practically during these sessions. And then the dedicated template for every and each. And then it may be your question now, if you want, will we go the new session live, going to be live from the 11th of December, that is a Saturday, 8 p.m. And then there we are covering the 30 plus existing labor law and the 4 new labor code, their practical learning. Then further, we have divided this program in the different 10 module. And however, here you will be get the 100 plus hours of the learning with this program, where the 75 hours of assured practical learning. Then you will learn with the concept of the WTS, which we have dwelt for learning of this program. Then there will be 33 existing labor law and 4 new codes. And then we have divided it with the 10 existing or different modules, where as per the relation of the existing labor law, like the law related to the working hour condition of services, that will be all the existing law will be covered in that, and the other law which will be covered as per the requirement, and then the new course will be separately covered for the provision. So here I'm sharing with you the course detailed curriculum, what we are covering in that. So as I mentioned that it is the for specifically for the 4 module specifically, and in that module, in the first module, we are covering the all the existing labor law which define or regulate the working hour condition of employment and services. So there we are covering the 10 existing labor law. Then the module number 2, which are the law related to defining the wages. So the 3 existing labor law, we are covering their practical aspect. Then the module number 3, which is related to the industrial relation, the existing labor law which regulate the industrial relation in the industries, so that we will be covered practically in the module number 3. And module number 4 is specifically related to the law which provide the equality and empowerment of the women, that we are covering their compliance perspective, as well as assuring of the different types of compliances and different types of records you are maintaining, and further the template and document you need to be prepared. And under the provision of the social security, what are the existing labor law available as of now? So we are covering that in the module number 5. So module number 6 is related to the prohibitive labor. What are the prohibitive labor in the different establishment, how you have to manage that, what are the requirement and procedure, and specifically this program is basically designing of the system and implementing that in the organization, so that you will be learned related to the prohibitive law in the module number 6. So here I'm sharing with you the curriculum specifically, when there are the specialist program from the next level also. So there, as for the curriculum of this program in the module number 7 specifically, we are covering the existing law which regulate and monitor the employment and training in the organization. There are the 2 existing labor law which are regulating and monitor the employment and training in the organization, that we are going to recover. Then the law related to the regulate the companies, even that are the companies which are the factories, and they are related to the companies, and the MSCC development, there are the companies which come under the MSCC, and then the provision of the income tax for the organization, and how you have to assure the tax friendly organization for your employee, so that you will be learned practically in the module number 8. And specifically here you are going to be learned that the job of the company secretary, what they do, when there you have to go for the 4 years of program for the company secretary specifically. But here you are learning that with the practical perspective, with this mastery program. And then the door related to the environment and the disaster that we are covering in the module number 9 and the practical aspect of the law which required to the facilitation of the different provision of the disaster and environment management. Then in the module number 10, that is specifically issued to the 4 new codes, its application and implementation and the provision that we are going to be learn practically and developing the standardization documents for the future implementation. So this is all about the curriculum of this mastery program where we are covering the 33 existing labor law and 4 new codes. So total 37 law will be covered and where you will be get the more than 75% hours of intensive learning practical, and then question and answer session will be separately 30 minutes a day. So it will be around 100% hours of learning. So now it comes to the question that if we are providing this much thing to that, what should be the fee for this organization, if anyone, if this program, if anyone want to go with this. So however, the price for this program we are keeping as 499, but you have joined our great learning legal community, so in that live session we have a special exclusive offer for the people who are going or who want to go with this program from today, or they will join. So in that you have to pay only the 2999 for this program, and those members will be go with this. They will have a live session, have the orientation session for this program on the Friday, and then from Saturday 11th of the December they will be get access to the live sessions. So now it come to the question, how you have to pay that. So there is the, we have different platform there where you can pay that, but further the member who are going with this program today, they will also get 2 additional program free of cost with this. So that is, one is the MS Excel mastery program where you will learn the advanced Excel, different type of function and formulation and dashboard preparing in the Excel. However, it is the mandatory requirement of the organization where most of the organization or businesses, they work on the Excel. And furthermore, there is the one new requirement of globally where you required a web identity now, so you can also learn how to develop and design the website for yourself. However, if you learn that, then after you can start your freelancing too. From the both one, these program cost the 28,000 rupees if the people go from the direct from our platform, but with this live master program of the 30-day mastery program, you are getting it free of cost today. So how you can enroll for the program? So there is the 2-3 platform we have already. So there is Paytm and Google also. However, we have the secure digital payment partner with the PayU. So there you will be get a link in the chat box now. So if any member want to go with this program, so they can check out this link and go with this program. So link has been shared with you. If anyone want to go with this program, this is live with accessing the 2 additional courses, so they can go with this program for this cost of 299. So this was all about this live session where we have learned about the existing issues related to the existing labor law and the issues for the employer, and then after the future perspective of the labor law in India and its impact on the industries. And also we have practically learned that how you have to prepare and be ready for the future when these new codes will be implemented. And further, if you have to assure become the specialist in the labor law compliance mastery, because in the future the labor law compliance is becoming the one of the growing job for the organization. It will help you in your career succeeding and developing the success skill of the labor law compliance specialist, so that you need to be definitely go with this program. So now the questions, whatever you have, you can ask. So we are going to be cover all those for further next. However, it is more than 6:39 now. We have started the program by 4:04. But however, how much time we will take it, we will cover those questions. Every question you have, we will try to cover up with that. And further, I have one request. to all the members. The certificate will be provided, participation certificate, on Wednesday. So before that, you need to be submit your name, whatever you want to do. However, already the name have been with us when you have registered, but there are, you required something name marked on the certificate, or certificate will be released to those people who will share their name. And we will share the certificate on the Wednesday only one time for one program. So it is required to, you need to be shared with all your names, what you want to mark on the certificate before the Wednesday 4 o'clock, and that the sharing through email, and you will get all those documented today, and there will be one noted in the bottom that you need to be share the name. It is not here, you need to be share it through the email, because I'm not taking it, or it will be collected by the backend team. So they required it on the WhatsApp group you have provided to the community, and secondly that through the mail you need to be share it there. So if you have any questions right now, so you can ask that, then we will cover up all that. And any member who want to go with this mastery program and enhancing their skill as a specialist, so they can also ask the question if they have any query in the session, and they can go with this program. And if you make the payment, because this program, if you are paying going directly, we charge for this program $5,999. But for this live program, you have already paid something, so you become the member of a Great Learning League, where you need to be also required to be connected with our platform, so where you can ask the query, we will provide a solution for that, even that interact with the other members too. So if you have any question, so you can ask, or if you want to ask the question in the verbal, so you can unmute yourself one by one, so you can ask the question, whatever you have written or whatever the query you have during these sessions, last 1, 2, and 30 minutes, which we have covered in this master program. So further, if you have any query related to the program, you can also ask that. So this program is exclusively for today, where you have to pay with this live program. So this is the $299 cost for the today or the live program. And after that, if you go from the our web portal, where you can check out that this program is available there, and if you check there, it will be cost for you $5,999. And if you have any question related to the different queries of the existing labor law, and further with the going to be implemented the new, or its implementation of the new codes, so whatever the queries you can ask, and so we can cover of that here within the next 10 minutes or maximum 5 to 10 minutes maximum. So then by 6:55 we will bind up this session today. Okay, Galaxy J7 Prime is saying thank you so much for the valuable session, sir. Thank you so much for you. And also one request, so when you will receive all that template, so you are required also to share the feedback of this session. How, what you learned from that, how this session was delivered. So you can also share, because the facilitator will also assessed by the promoter of this platform, and that it will also provide us the opportunity to improve it further. So whatever the point you consider that required to be improved, you can also share that on the email also, as well as the WhatsApp group. And you may have our the backend team's numbers also. So you can also share that. Thank you so much, Pundik Patil, that to be very good session. Okay, thank you so much. So here, if you have any question, please ask in the chat box, otherwise you can unmute yourself. Otherwise with the next 2 minutes, I will bind up the session here. And the video will be available by tomorrow. It will be shared a link through email with you. Thank you so much for all for your comments on the session. Please share the presentation and template will be shared with you. Present will not be shared, but instead of the presentation, you will get the video of that, where you can utilize that video specifically. You can capture a screenshot of that, you can utilize that. Otherwise, all that templates which we have shared with you in this live session, that will be reached to you after completion of this program, but not the immediately after, maybe today before ending of this day, you will reach all those templates today itself. So don't worry for that. And the community link already submitted or already shared with you on email. So there is provided to community. One is the Telegram as well as the WhatsApp community available for the live session or the Level of Compliance Mastery program. So you can check out there. If it is not there, so you just ping on the number. You may have the number of our backend team. So you can also ping there. Okay, don't worry. So we will share it that. Don't worry for that. We will share it again on your WhatsApp number or your email also. So don't worry for that. Patel is asking that, that is our that paid version is not working. So that's why today we are working on the unpaid or the free version. So that's why it was disconnected between the 14 minute. But in the further, we have already the paid and professional version for that. So the next, if you are joining in the next session also, so we will get in the continuation. Okay, no one has any question related to the session. So I hope everyone learn the best practices and implement these practices in your organization, and hope for your great learning with us as well as the future. A presentation, the document will not be shared. The video will be reached to in the form of the presentation. So you can utilize that for your reference. That will be a lifetime access to you when you required. How many times you want to go with that, you can check out that. Everything will be available there. So we do not keep anything hidden from you. So what we have mentioned, so that will be reached to you as it is, even more of that. Not few templates, that all templates will be reached which we have shared. However, there are the another templates which we does not share in the live session, so it will be shared with you also. So don't worry for that. Whatever is related to the implementation of the Level of Compliance Management portfolio, every support will be provided to you so that you can develop that system, your organization, and rebuild or that credibility of your personal credibility as well as the organize the department as the human resources in your organization, so that every in that the professional who are into the HR services as well, the professional, they can progress in their career and have a strong domain practices specifically for their domain working. So thank you so much for Rahul Sachdeva. That be a wonderful learning session. Welcome you again. And also requested to all the member, share your name for the certificate. So the certificate will be released by Wednesday. So you are have to submit the name by Wednesday 4 p.m. After, if you send that, after that it will not be considered. So you need to be wait for the certificate, because we release the certificate for the session one time only, and so that will be released on Wednesday. So that's why we keep some time for releasing of the certificate. Thank you so much for all the participants in joining in the today's session. So I hope that everyone learned something new and the advanced concept that you can implement in your organization to helping your employer or the organization to grow and saving such money as well as the complying them as per the requirement, as per the provision, under the provision of the different level law. Thank you so much for joining of this session today. Here we are binding this session, and every document which we have shared with you and which we have commented, so that will be reached to you as on the time we have commented with you.